Good morning, everybody. Today we are going to deal with the second practical lab of agricultural microbiology course and nutrient media. So we have to know about the definition of nutrient media, their types and their preparation. Firstly, the definition of nutrient media, they are cultures which are designed to provide all the essential nutrients in solution for bacterial growth. They should composed of H donors and acceptors, carbon source, nitrogen source, other inorganic nutrients, solidifying agents, buffer chemicals, dissolved in a solvent, usually distilled water. So what are the uses of a nutrient medium? They are used to enrichment of microbial cultures, studying the different characteristics of microorganisms, studying the effect of microbial growth on media components, production of important end products such as amino acids, alcohols, antibiotics, organic acids, and enzymes. So what are the types of a nutrient media? They are classified depending on many factors. Depending on their composition, they are classified into synthetic media and routine media. Routine media are classified into six types, such as basal media, enriched media, selective media, indicator media, transport media, and storage media. While synthetic or defined media, these are chemically defined media prepared from pure chemical substances, which is used in research work. So depending on its consistency, they are classified into two types of media. The first one is solid media and the second one is liquid media. The solid media has a solid state at room temperature. They are used for the isolation of bacteria as pure culture. Agar is the most commonly used chemical to prepare solid media. While liquid media has a liquid state at room temperature, they are used to profuse growth such as blood culture in liquid media. Mixed organisms can't be separated in these types of media. The second type of nutrient media, they are routine laboratory media. They include six types of media. The first one is basal media. It is used for growth of bacteria that don't need any enrichment of the media, such as nutrient broth, nutrient agar, and peptone water. Staphylococcus and Enterobacteriaceae grow well in these media. The second type of routine media is enriched media. Enriched media are usually enriched by adding blood, serum, or egg, such as blood agar. Streptococci grow well in blood agar media. The third type of routine media are selective media. These media favor the growth of a particular bacterium by inhibiting the growth of all undesired ones and allowing the growth of only one desirable bacteria, such as McConkie agar and tellurite media. Tellurite inhibits the growth of most of the throat organisms except diphtheria bacilli, so antibiotic may be added to a medium as selective agent. The fourth type of routine media, indicator media or differential media, these media usually is supported by adding an indicator to support the growth of more than one microbial group. A particular organism causes a change in the indicator while the other cannot make this change. So blood, neutral red, and telluride are good examples of indicator media. The fifth type of routine media are transport media. These media are used when a specimen cannot be cultured soon after collection. So carry player medium, Ames medium, and Stewart medium are good examples of transport media. The last type of routine media is called storage media. This media used for storing the bacteria for a long period of time, such as egg saline medium, chalk cooked meat, broth. So how to prepare media in the laboratory? First, you should have some materials and equipments, which are distilled water, pH indicator paper, or pH meter. How to practice this? Firstly, you should measure the components of the medium. Please dissolve all components and fill the solvent up to final volume. Check the pH of the medium with a pH meter. Complete a whole sterilization cycle for 20 minutes at 1 to 1 centigrade. For slant preparation, please put the test tubes onto a slanting stage to let the medium solidify in the test tubes. Note, important note here. Prepared media can't be stored for 1 or 2 weeks at 12 to 15 centigrades or longer in a refrigerator. Please don't store medium containing agar-agar under 4 to 5 centigrades as it destroys its structure. So what are the examples for nutrient media? We have two types of media. The first one is fungal media, which supports the growth of fungi, and bacterial media, which supports the growth of bacteria, such as nutrient protein agar, glucose protein agar, while fungal media, such as natural media, like potato dextrose agar and malt extract agar, while synthetic ones, such as Richard and Zabbix. So thank you for your listening, and see you soon, or meet you soon, at the third practical lab of agricultural microbiology course.